Hey guys, welcome back. This is Donald with Silver Spinning Reviews, and this is Life is Strange, episode 4, The Dark Room. I think this may be chapter 4, episode 4. It's all the same. I have the hiccups all of a sudden. I'm sorry, guys. Which is...
Sorry to bother you again, Samuel.
There's no... Oh, God, I can't stop one. People.
More questions than answers.
Samuel is always here to talk.
Blackwell is so sad and quiet since Kate isn't here anymore.
Yes. You can tell that the campus is different now. And you reached out to her when everybody turned away.
It could have gone either way. Samuel, do you think that we each have a destiny?
Yes, I do, Max. In many different lifetimes, of course. Kate Marsh believed in something different, so that's her destiny.
I believe you.
Kate just needed some more helpful spirits like her friend Max. I hope she finds them now.
Have you seen Nathan Prescott around?
That would be hard since he was suspended.
You don't sound sad, Samuel.
Nathan hurts people. The end.
What do you really know about him?
Not enough to help you, Max. I truly wish I could. I see what you're doing.
Do you ever talk with David Madsen?
He talks to me. I listen.
That's how David operates.
He sees things, not people. But I think he sees you, Max.
Why do you say that?
Because... you both see with cameras.
I think you have better vision than both of us.
No, Max. I just look at everything from a different angle.
I was just about to say that. Holy shit.
I still have a million questions about what's happening to Arcadia Bay.
That must be why Miss Gant says you're one of her favorite students at Blackwell.
Even though Miss Grant likes me, I have zero science skills to explain that eclipse.
As I was just saying to her, that's because science has no explanation. No offense to Miss Graham here, but this is just the beginning.
How do you know that? I'm genuinely curious.
You just have to open your eyes. Then you can see what's coming. That's why I can sense something bigger is coming to Arcadia Bay. And Max, I don't like it at all.
Who the hell are you, dude?
I keep thinking that Rachel Amber has a few answers. If we can find her.
If Rachel wants to be found.
That's the real secret. Where is she?
If anybody knows, it will be you. My dreams tell me that.
But...
Max, all I can tell you is to stay on your path, and you'll find what you're looking for. Rachel Amber is waiting, too.
I'd rather be in her class than the Vortex Club.
Yes, you would. Rachel saw right through them.
She's not the only one.
Nobody should be trapped in the Vortex Club. Get out now, Max, while time is on your side.
I definitely have...
Oh.
What do you think about all those dying birds?
Samuel had to bury dozens near the Tabanga.
Is that cool with the Tabanga?
We'll find out if the souls of the bird move on. Not we can prove it.
It's so ominous.
Unless it's fate, then it doesn't matter.
I'm sorry. I better get going now.
Hello. Wow. Okay, that took much longer than I thought it would, but we didn't have our celebratory cheers, guys, so, to the start of a new episode. 3, 2, 1, cheers.
Hi, Miss Grant.
Max, you always show up when I'm talking about you. I'm still bragging about you and the other students making Blackwell surveillance for you.
I was hoping you could explain some of these crazy things happening in Arcadia Bay.
If I could, I'd be collecting my Nobel Prize in Science today. I haven't been able to wrap my mind around that eclipse, much less the snow in Wales.
There must be a scientific explanation, right?
When my friends at NASA tell me they can't explain a solar eclipse without a single theory as to how or why, maybe it's time to get worried, like they are.
I am worried about reality. I feel like it's changing right in front of us.
You and Samuel both. We were talking about that before you came over. Our planet is changing, but it's not mystic. It's erosion.
So, you don't think this could be some kind of prophecy or something?
Max, you know how fascinated I am by Arcadia Bay legends. But I haven't found any apocalyptic signs yet. Unless you count those end-of-the-world posters. Unless you know something I don't.
What about wormholes and chaos theory? Like time travel stuff.
The only wormholes in Arcadia Bay are underground. And chaos theory is just that. But if this is about time travel, sign me up.
Would you really change time?
Not after reading that Bradbury story, A Sound of Thunder. I won't give it away, but it involves dinosaurs and butterflies. Time is like a thread, Max. One tug and it all can unravel.
That's not how threads work, that's how the fucking carpet works, but whatever.
I was looking for Nathan Prescott and thought he might be in your class.
Mr. Prescott has no class at all after his suspension. I didn't think you were friends.
Those are best of friends.
You probably know him better.
I've tried. Nathan is a Prescott, and with that comes a lot of baggage. Too much for one teenager. This week was the proof. Principal Wells did the right thing.
I know. Nathan needs real help.
Yes, he does, man. I did try once, but Mr. Prescott didn't appreciate my help. I did see Nathan leaving the campus looking angrier than usual, so maybe it's good you haven't found her.
I don't think surveillance would have helped Kate Marsh.
Oh, Max. I'm so sorry you had to go through that. Kate is the sweetest student I've ever met at Blackwell. And they can be so cruel to each other. Do you need to talk to a counselor?
No thanks, Miss Grant. I have my best friend and my parents. For now.
I'm happy to hear that, Max. Just don't ever be afraid to talk to somebody, okay? I wish Kate had come to me. I had no idea what she was going through.
Kate was drugged at the Vortex Club party and bullied by them until she ended up on the roof. How do you stop that?
Shut down that damn Vortex Club for a start. I don't mean to get riled up, but that party should have been postponed. It's extremely tasteless given what happened with Kate.
Do the Prescotts have anything to do with the Vortex Club? I mean, they don't get all their money from car washes.
No, they don't. But membership has its privileges. Especially when your father is Blackwell's biggest sponsor. This elitist nonsense has no place here.
You're right. I just wish this could be the school that I dreamed about before I came here.
I hear you, Max. I love seeing you and Warren and all my students at your best here. But you're all too young to be so cynical. But you truly give me hope.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant. I have to get going. I'll see you later.
It's always good talking to you, Max.
Kate.
When they spill their name on in candles. Well, aren't you guys a bunch of bitches?
Justin, it's been so long since
I can tell that Justin is really into Chloe.
For us now, Chloe. Way too much shit going on.
So keep talking to people for a minute.
Hey, Daniel. You look bummed out. Are you alright?
Hola, Max. I just figured out that my photos basically suck. I'm a wannabe artist.
You're not here to be a photographer. That's my gig. Look at that sketch you did of me. Incredible. And that's your art. Your gift.
I do feel better now. You are good, Max.
Have you talked to anybody about what happened with Kate?
I don't talk to anybody, Max. But, I did actually have a conversation with Brooke. She was very sad about Kate.
So am I. And angry.
We should stop going to class and stage a protest. But that's not going to happen at Blackwell. Yet.
I like this revolutionary Daniel Da Costa.
Only if I can start the revolution from my sketchbook, Max.
By the way, have you seen Nathan Prescott?
Oh, I heard a rumor he's actually suspended.
Yeah, but he's still gotta be on campus.
That explains why he looked so pissed off when I saw him leaving campus a few moments ago.
Are you going to the end of the world party tonight?
It will be if I go, man. People here push me in the lockers, not dance floors.
That's exactly why you should go to that party. We have to stand up to these Blackwell bullies for Kate. You won't be alone, Daniel.
Not with you to back me up, Max. Oh, damn it. I will go to the party like it is the end of the world.
Damn right.
Maybe I won't go, but... No, I won't do that, but... I'll go.
Let's talk later.
What?
Okay, Daniel.
Oh, I just fucked with shit. It's gonna be great. So can't wait for him to go. Can I talk to you? But I should be able to talk to this guy. Yeah, Zach.
Enjoy the big game, Zachary. I hope it's not the last.
It'll absolutely be the last. Oh, wait. Is there something right here? What's this? Rachel owes me money. Pay up, bitch. Lovely. Oh, they're so gonna bang.
Coast is clear. It would be so cool if you and me were going to school here together. But now you can have Mr. Jefferson all to yourself. Ugh, you suck. Now let's get into Blackwell Ninja Mode. It's so lame they don't have colored dorms here. Yes, because I want Nathan Prescott in the room next door. Good point. Wait here. Give me the signal if Nathan or anybody shows up.
I won't let you down, Batmax.
Now I just have to find Nathan's room.
Clearly that was stained glass. He's not gonna see anything that way.
Evan. Of course. That's why no shits were given. Evan rolls. Who needs a dorm map anyway? At least I can see that Nathan isn't in room 106 or 108.
Wow.
Who would steal cat pics?
I just feel like there's a fucking shouting going on.
Why, hello, Trevor. And Dana.
Nah, fuck them both.
This can only be Nathan's room.
Nah, we'll come back to it in a second. I'm gonna take a look around.
Oh, you Bigfoots.
Okay.
Looks like one of the jocks did care about Kate. Poor Warren. This is the work of Nathan.
Beta fag alert, I guess.
Hello, Warren's room. Hawking and him make a good team.
There's... Wait. Oh, I'm gonna write here.
I can have a little fun with Warren for a change. I mean, he's the one who wants to go ape. And sometimes you have to take a chance and see what happens. I hope Warren doesn't think that's too...
Are you made of copper and beryllium?
I mean,
because
like
you're...
Because
you're cute.
Right?
Wow.
This just makes me think of Kate.
I think that's the point, to be honest.
Ugh, skunk weed and video games. I sense Hayden is near. Zach or Logan? Who knows? Bro's got a bro. Oh, sharks. At least nobody messed with the Kate portrait.
Cry, hipster, cry.
Even after Kate, nobody here learned anything about bullying.
God, this is supposed to be like an elite private school.
Are toilet paper wars mandatory in the dorms?
It seems so very strange and everything is so goddamn decrepit around here.
Now
what?
I need to find Nathan's phone. Or anything with... Yes.
What the fuck does Joyce want? Okay.
I would be cool with having this high... Yes, I would be cool with having this high-tech projector. That looks like a totally fun show. Even Nathan has a light side. That must be the lamp Chloe broke when Nathan drugged her. Whale songs? Maybe this is the only soothing thing Nathan ever hears.
Huh. Hey, nope. Turn it on. Unless it turns off.
That is so Chloe.
Okay. Oh, wait. I think there was more there. Excuse me.
That is... Oh my god. Chloe. Chloe.
I actually don't really... Really wish I hadn't seen that.
Nathan clearly has his fetish down. So cute and ironic. I can't believe Nathan still has it around.
I can't believe a father would give that to his son like that.
That monochrome camera is brand new and costs about $6,000. Bastard. I thought Victoria had the photo bling, but once again, the press got
the next
rolled.
Photo I'm looking for, by the way, which is kind of why I'm screwing around with everything, is...
I don't think this prescription has helped me.
Looks like, what's it, footprints in the sand? Yeah, some type of footprints. Nothing on the ground here.
I'd cry too if I had him for a father and had to wear that suit.
That suit's pretty terrible.
Holy shit. That's the gun Nathan used on Chloe. A gift from... Nathan likes his tortured subjects way too much. These films all have a dark pattern. Oh man, that dickhead stole one of my selfies.
He's into you in a creepy sort of
Nathan
psychopathic
took this
way.
From Kate's altar. Why? What is with this dude?
That's a super good question. I'm not gonna watch that. That's creepy.
Nathan is way into this party. Bad sign.
Okay.
Bastard. Now I remember why I hate you. And why Kate will get justice.
What? We can't watch it?
Oh,
lame.
Sean Prescott might be Nathan's real problem.
Okay. Don't fuck it up, son. Your father.
Too bad Nathan isn't more like his sister. She sounds awesome. And far away.
She totally seems to love him. How
yes,
weird.
Nathan sure needs diet pills. This is strong. Wow. Kiss ass much, Principal Wells.
Wow. What am I supposed to be doing here? I'm investigating her, but I didn't think I found... Oh, here, maybe. How did I miss this shit?
I don't think one book can guide the Prescotts. Damn, Nathan. That's a nice shot. It's so damn creepy, but... the guy has his own... Oh, Jesus. Nathan is...
Is that the dog we killed? Oh, no. We totally killed the dog last episode, and I feel really bad about it, but it's what happened, and we're moving on. What? How am I supposed to... Wait, what?
What the hell are all those marks on the floor?
It looks like the couch moved out. We're going to grab the couch. We're gonna
move. Let's find out what you're hiding.
Okay.
Oh yes, little phone. You are mine now. Now I have Nathan's phone, so I can show it to Chloe. Or before Nathan comes back.
Nah, I think we're okay.
I thought Victoria had the photo bling, but...
No, we're out.
Once again, the Prescott's rule.
I looked at everything.
Damn, Max, you're finally back. I got worried. So what did you find?
His room was clean and creepy. Check this out.
Boom, Nathan. We got you by the balls, fucker.
Oh, shit.
What are you doing in my dorm? You're such a nosy bitch, Max.
Stop right there, Nathan.
Make me ho. Max, I got this.
Goddamn, Warren.
Get the fuck out of my face.
Jesus.
You are so fucking dead. Get off me, bro.
Get off me, bro. No, fuck that. Stop, Warren. Don't want to fucking kill him.
Stop it. Come on.
Oh, my hand. Why are y'all looking at me like that, huh? You and you, you're all dead.
Let's go. Now.
Plus, my dad is on his way. You're all fucked. He owns you.
I like that it gives me the chance to rewind, but...
We should try to be better than that.
Yeah, no, I'm totally happy with what happened, to be perfectly honest.
Damn, that was intense. Warren, thank you so much.
For what?
For headbutting Nathan Prescott. That was awesome.
I don't know. I almost went crazy there. Like Nathan.
You're not anything like
good to know. So where are you going? I better stick with you guys, just in case you need me to get my Hulk on again. Or should I call the cops on Nathan?
No police. Not yet. So maybe you better,
come with us.
Me and Max have to do this on our own.
No, I would have invited him.
Whatever I can do to help.
What you can do is find out anything you can about Nathan's father.
I'm on it. Between the snow and eclipse, I'm assuming the apocalypse is around the corner.
And thank you. Seriously. I'll call you later.
Dude, you are so out of date.
I'm feeling pretty alpha now.
Yes, you are.
We're gonna give it up. If I get the chance, we're gonna give it up to this stuff.
Man, that guy is so fucking in love with you.
I know.
He really did give a serious beat down to Nathan.
It was a little scary to watch him do that.
Scary?
Let's make a date with Frank.
Will he even answer you?
Oh, we owe him money,
Frank,
remember?
Frank always answers when he wants money.
Thank you.
Like I said, Frank wants to see me right now.
Let's not keep him waiting.
I'm sure that has nothing to do with us fucking over with his RV the last time we screwed him. I'm thinking this is where we get the footprints in the sand, and the, I think there was like a fin, hold on, real quick, oh, I guess I can't do, no, here it is, see, there's footprints in the sand, and it looks like a whale's fin.
God, they hate seeing those poor whales like that.
Me too. I just think of their families in the ocean, they're looking for them. Well, that asshole's gonna help us find Rachel.
Or what? You'll actually shoot him? Chloe, do not count on my rewind. Seriously.
Obviously, I'm not counting on you. That's why I have a gun. And I might even save you someday.
About
no,
time.
You keep saying that,
I am
but...
so going to hit you. There's no way we could have guessed this is what would happen to us when we grew up.
I'm looking forward to the day when we can just go on a road trip to Portland.
Fuck yeah. You, me... Rachel.
Absolutely. So let's play this cool, okay? Just pay Frank his money, and then we can get that code for the book from him. That's all.
Got it. No dicking around.
Let's roll.
Oh, she's so gonna murder him.
Nope, I don't want to go there.
There's like sand everywhere. Oh, maybe... No. I don't know if it's supposed to be before. Or what?
Frank doesn't need tinted windows when they're this dirty. This is where my nightmare started.
Yeah, it is. Oh, nice. What am I running into?
There might not be any Panda States by Saturday. I may not know quantum speak, but there has to be an explanation.
There we go. So that's that one. But I didn't get the beat one, so I'm
it
assuming that has
my mind that I was just here with Chloe in an alternate reality. The forest seemed quiet. No sign of life. Or deer.
I don't want to go that way.
Oh, I missed it. I don't know where that one is. It must have been in the dorms or something. Unless it's around this side. We'll deal with you in a minute.
This is where Frank ponders his existence and gets drunk.
I don't know why you can't do both. Your condescending attitude is unappreciated. Oh,
goddammit.
This is where
Frank ponders his existence.
Stop it.
And gets drunk. take the trash out sometime, dude.
To be honest, I thought it was a backpack. You're over here, got it.
Behold, Frank's beer garden. Good thing there are no actual cops around to bust us.
Damn it, that upsets me. I've been doing so well.
Aw, poor little beach ball.
It's super dead. Just like these whales.
I may not know quantum speak, but there has to be an explanation.
There is a fucking half dozen of them. Ugh.
How can all of this not be connected to a major storm?
Okay, we're moving on. I tried to find the fifth one, but we seem to have skipped to the sixth one.
Can't see inside with this shit blocking the view.
Here it goes. Actually, shit. I didn't realize how, we were like 32 minutes in. We're gonna go ahead and call this episode quits, guys. Again, this is Dominic with Silver Screen Reviews, and thank you for watching this episode of Life is Strange, Episode 4, Darkroom. If you guys enjoyed it, leave a like down below. Let me know you appreciate the content, you want more of it, all the good jazz. If you have any comments, criticisms, suggestions, critiques, leave it down in the comment section below. I love hearing from you guys. Otherwise, have a good night, and I will see you in the next part.